एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द नेक्स्ट मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी, नेम इज क्वार्टाइल्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ क्वार्टाइल्स. द ऑब्जर्वेशंस Q1, Q2, Q3 विच डिवाइड्स द डेटा इंटू फोर इक्वल पार्ट्स व्हेन डेटा अरेंज्ड इन असेंडिंग और डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी लर्न द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मेडियन. What is mean by median? Median is the middle most observation which divides the data into how many equal parts? Two equal parts when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Similarly, there are the three quartiles Q1, Q2 and Q3 which divides the data into four equal parts when data arranged in ascending or descending order. There are three quartiles Q1, Q2, Q3 which divide the data into how many equal parts? Four equal parts. Median is single value which divide the data into two equal parts. Okay, now see the case one. For ungrouped data, what is the formula for calculating the quartiles for ungrouped data? Formula is Qy is equal to I in bracket n plus 1 divided by fourth observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order, where small n is number of observations. And what is the value of I here? I is 1, 2 and 3 because there are the three quartiles Q1, Q2 and Q3. Now see example, calculate Q1, Q2, Q3 for following data. The data we are given only the values of x, that means the data is ungrouped data. So data values are 26, 30, 35, 5, 6, 7, 9, 20, 40, 45, 11, 18, 15, 49 and last is 60. So to find out the quartiles values, first need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Here the ascending order data is 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 15, 18, 20, 26, 30, 35, 40, 45, 49 and last is 16. And here n, that means the number of observations, value is 15. That means there are total 15 observations in given example. So first find out the Q1. For finding the value of Q1, put I is equal to 1. Okay, so what is the formula for calculating the quartiles? Qy is equal to I in bracket n plus 1 divided by fourth observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order. So first put I is equal to 1. So Qy, that means Q1 is equal to, put I is equal to 1. So 1 into in bracket n plus 1 divided by fourth observations. So here n value is 15. Now plug the value of n is equal to 15 in the formula. So in next step, Q1 is equal to 1 into in bracket 15 plus 1 divided by fourth observation. So 15 plus 1, that is 16. 16 divided by 4, that is fourth observation. So which one is the fourth observation in given series of data? That is 9. So our Q1 value is 9. Now see how to calculate Q2. For Q2, put I value is equal to 2 in the formula. So the formula we will get, Q2 is equal to 2 into in bracket n plus 1 divided by fourth observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Now just plug the value of n is equal to 15 in the formula. So 2 into in bracket 15 plus 1 divided by fourth observation. So 15 plus 1, that is 16. 16 divided by 4, that means 4. So 4 into 2, that is 8 observations. So which one is the 8th observation here? So 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 value is 20. So here the Q2 value is 20. Now the last Q3. For Q3, just put I is equal to 3 in the formula. So Q3 is equal to 3 into in bracket n plus 1 divided by fourth observation
when data arranged in ascending or descending order. So 3 in bracket, what is the value of N15? So 15 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. So 15 plus 1 divided by 4, that means 4. So 4 into 3, that is 12th observation. So which one is the 12th observation here? The observation, 12th observation is, value is 40. So our Q3 value is 40. So this is the method for calculating the quartiles for ungrouped data. Now see next example. Calculate the quartiles, that is Q1, Q2, Q3 for following data. The data we are given 49, 36, 66, 41, 44, 41, 76, 53 and last is 11. For finding the quartiles, we need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Here ascending order data is 36, 41, 41, 44, 49, 53, 66, 71 and last is 76. And here the total number of observations, that is small n value, is 9. That means there are 9 observations we are given in example. Now for finding the Q1, put I is equal to 1 in the formula. So what is the formula for calculating the quartiles? Qi is equal to I in bracket n plus 1 divided by 4th observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order. So for finding Q1, put I is equal to 1. So Q1 is equal to 1 into in bracket n plus 1 divided by 4th observation. Now plug the value of n is equal to 9 in the formula. So the Q1 is equal to 1 into in bracket 9 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. So 9 plus 1, that is 10, 10 divided by 4th. So 10 divided by 4 is 2.5th observation. So how to calculate the 2.5th observation? This 2.5 is written as 2 plus 0.5. So the first digit is 2. So second observation plus remaining part as it is plus 0.5. After the second observation, there is the third observation. So third minus second observation. Now just plug the second observation value, third observation value in the formula. So which one is the second observations we are given in example? The second observations in ascending order data is 41. So 41 plus 0.5 as it is into in bracket third observation is again 41 minus second is 41. So 41 minus 41, that is 0. 0 into 0.5, that is 0. Then 0 plus 41, that is 41. So Q1 value is 41 here. Now see how to calculate Q2. For finding the value of Q2, put I is equal to 2 in the formula. So I is equal to 2. What is the formula? Qi is equal to I in bracket n plus 1 divided by 4th observation. Now put I is equal to 2. So 2 into n plus 1 divided by 4th observation. And now plug the value of n is equal to 9 in the formula. So Q2 is equal to 2 into in bracket 9 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. So 9 plus 1 divided by 4, that is 2.5. So 2 into 2.5, that is 5th observation. So which one is the 5th observation? So 5th observation value is 49. So our Q2 value is 49. Okay, now the third quartile is, put I is equal to 3 in the formula. So formula is I in bracket n plus 1 divided by 4th observations. So put I is equal to 3. So 3 into n plus 1 divided by 4th observations when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Now plug the value of n is equal to 9 in the formula. So 3 into in bracket 9 plus 1 divided by 4th. So 9 plus 1, that is 10. 10 divided by 4 is 2.5. So 3 into 2.5. So 3 into 2.5, that is 7.5. observation. So how to calculate 7.5th observation? So 7.5th observation is calculated as, this 7.5 is written as 7 plus 0.5. So first digit is 7. So 7th observation plus remaining part as it is 0.5. After the 7th observation, there is 8th observation. 8 minus previous one, that is 7th observation. Now just plug the value of 7th observation, 8th observation in the formula. So which one is the 7th observations in example? The 7th observation is 66. So 66 plus 0.5 as it is. 8th observation is 71. 71 minus 66. So 71 minus 66 is 5. So 5 into 0.5, that is 2.5. So 66 plus 2.5, that is 68.5. So Q3 value is 68.5. So this is the method for calculating the quartiles for ungrouped data. Now see case 2 for group data. So how to calculate the quartiles in a group case? So first step is to calculate LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency. Second step is calculate IN divided by 4, where capital N is total frequency and I value is 1, 2, 3, because there are 3 quartiles which divide the data into 4 equal parts. Okay, now last step 3, see the LCF just greater than IN divided by 4, then corresponding value of X is ith quartile. Now see in example, here the data we are given X along with their frequency, called as the group data. So for calculating the quartiles in group case, first step is to calculate LCF. So how to calculate LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency? Write down first frequency value as it is, so 2 as it is. Then first LCF value plus second frequency value, so 2 plus 5, that is 7. Then 7 plus 7, that is 14. Then 14 plus 13, that is 27. Then 27 plus 21, that is 48. Then 48 plus 6, 54. 54 plus 8, 62. 62 plus 3, 65. And here capital N is 65, that is total frequency, sum of column of F. Now how to calculate Q1? So for finding the value of Q1, put I is equal to 1. Okay. So first step for finding the quartiles is to calculate LCF. Now second step is calculate IN divided by 4. Put I is equal to 1 and capital N is 65 divided by 4. So 1 into 65 divided by 4. So value is 16.25. Now see the LCF just greater than 16.25. So which LCF value is just greater than 16.25? Here the LCF value 27 is just greater than 16.5. So the corresponding value of X is first quartile. So here the Q1 is equal to 17.5. Now for finding the Q2. For finding Q2, put I is equal to 2. So second step is calculate IN divided by 4. So 2 into 65 divided by 4. So value is 32.5. Now see the LCF just greater than 32.5. So here which LCF is just greater than 32.5? So here the LCF 48 is just greater than 32.5. So the corresponding value of X is second quartile. So here the Q2 is equal to 22.5. So that is second quartile value is 22.5. Similarly for Q3, put I is equal to 3. So IN divided by 4. So 3 into 65 divided by 4. So value is 48.75. So which LCF value is just greater than 48.75? Here 54 LCF value is just greater than 48.75. So the corresponding value of X is 27.5 is third quartile. So third quartile value is 27.5. So this is the method for finding the quartiles in group data. Now see the third case, continuous data. So how to calculate the quartiles in continuous case? The first step is to calculate LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency. So second step is calculate IN divided by 4, where capital N is total frequency and I values are 1, 2, 3. There are 3 quartiles. Now third step, see the LCF just greater than IN divided by 4, then corresponding class is ith quartile class. Continuous data means we are given the classes along with their frequency. Okay, so what is the formula for calculating the quartiles in continuous case? Qi is equal to L plus IN divided by 4 minus Cf upon F into H, where L is the lower limit of ith quartile class, F is the frequency of ith quartile class, h is the class width of ith quartile class, and cf is the LCF value before ith quartile class. Now see example. Calculate the quartiles for following data. The data we are given, the classes along with their frequency. That means the given data is continuous data. Okay, now first calculate the first quartile Q1. So how to calculate the first quartile? For finding the value of Q1, put I is equal to 1. So what is the first step for calculating the quartiles in continuous case? First step is to calculate LCF. Then second step is calculate IN divided by 4. Okay, so first calculate LCF. How to calculate LCF? First frequency value as it is, so 12 as it is. Then 12 plus 22, that is 34. Then 34 plus 28, that is 62. Then 62 plus 38, that is 100. Then 100 plus 37, that is 137. So 137 plus 29, that is 166. 166 plus 20, that is 186. And last, 186 plus 14, that is 200. Here capital N, that is total frequency, sum of column of f is 200. Now for finding Q1, put I is equal to 1. Okay, so the second step is calculate IN divided by 4. So put I is equal to 1. So 1 into, what is the capital N value? 200 divided by 4. So here 200 divided by 4 value is 50. So see the LCF just greater than 50. Here which LCF value is just greater than 50? Here the LCF 62 is just greater than 50. So the corresponding class is first quartile class. So our first quartile class is 4 to 6. Okay. So for first quartile class, we need the value of L, that is lower limit, CF value, that is LCF value before quartile class, F is the frequency of quartile class, and H is the class width. So L is the lower limit of first quartile class. So our lower limit of first quartile class is 4. So here the L value is 4. Now the second is IN divided by 4 value. So IN divided by 4 value is 50. We already calculated. Okay, now the CF value. CF value means LCF value before quartile class. So our first quartile class is 4 to 6. So which LCF value is before that quartile class? So our 34 LCF value is before quartile class, first quartile class. So our CF value is 34. Then F. F is the frequency of first quartile class. So what is the frequency of that class? 28. So F value is 28. And last, H. H is the class width. So how to calculate the class width? Class width is calculated as upper limit minus lower limit. So upper limit is 6 and lower limit is 4. So 6 minus 4, that is 2. So our H value is 2. Now just plug all the values in the formula. So L is 4. Then IN divided by 4 value is 50, CF is 34, and F is 28, and H is 2. Then 50 minus 34, that is 16, divided by 28, multiply by 2. Then 16 divided by 28, that is 0.5714, multiply by 2, that is 1.1428. So 4 plus 1.1428, that is 5.1428. So the first quartile value is 5.1428. One thing is, remember that quartile value is always lies between quartile class. So our value is 5.1428 is lies in 4 to 6 class. Okay, now see how to calculate second quartile. So for second quartile, put I is equal to 2, then IN divided by 4. So put I is equal to 2, 2 into capital N is 200 divided by 4. So this value is 100. Now see the LCF just greater than 100, not equal to 100, just greater than 100. So here the LCF value 137 is just greater than 100. So the corresponding class is second quartile class, because here we are finding the value of Q2. So the second quartile class is 8 to 10. Okay, what is the lower limit of that class? Lower limit of that class is 8. Okay, what is the CF? CF is the LCF value before the second quartile class. So LCF value before the second quartile class is 100. Then F is the frequency of second quartile class. So what is the frequency? 37. And last, H is the class width. So upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit is 10, lower limit is 8. So 10 minus 8, that is 2. Now just plug all the values in the formula. So Q2 is equal to L is 8, IN divided by 4 value is 100. Then CF value is 100, F is the 37, and H's value is 2, that is class width. 100 minus 100, that is 0. 0 divided by 37, that is 0. 0 into 2, that is 0. So 8 plus 0, that is 2. So Q2 is equal to 8. And this Q2 is nothing but the median, always. Okay. Now see, for Q3, put I is equal to 3. So first calculate IN divided by 4. I is 3, so 3 into capital N is 200 divided by 4, so value is 150. Now see the LCF value just greater than 150. So which LCF value is just greater than 150? So here the LCF value 166 is just greater than 150. So the corresponding class is third quartile class, because here we are finding Q3. So the third quartile class is 10 to 12. So L is the lower limit of quartile class, so lower limit is 10. H is the class width of quartile class. How to calculate the class width? Upper limit minus lower limit, so 12 minus 10, that is 2. Then CF is the LCF value before quartile class. So here the 137 LCF is before that class, so 137 value. And the last, F is the frequency of quartile class. What is the frequency of that class? 29. Now plug all the values in the formula. L is 10, IN divided by 4 value is 150, CF is 137, H is 2, and F is 29. Okay, now 10, 150 minus 137, that is 13, divided by 29 as it is. Multiply by 2, then 13 divided by 29, that is 0.448276. Multiply by 2, that is 0.896552. Plus 10, that is 10.8965552. This is the value of third quartiles. Okay, so this is the method for finding the quartiles in continuous case. Now see how to calculate the quartiles by graphically. To find out the quartiles by using graph, we used Ogive curve. There are two types of Ogive curve, less than Ogive curve and more than Ogive curve. Used either any one. Here I am using the less than Ogive curve. How to draw the less than Ogive curve? Take upper limit on x-axis, that is upper class boundary, and LCF on y-axis. But for drawing the Ogive curve, we need the classes is in exclusive form. Our the given classes is already in exclusive form. So no need to convert it. Okay, so take upper limit on x-axis and LCF on y-axis and plot the points on xy plane and join these points by the smooth curve. The graph is called as the less than Ogive curve. Okay. So what is the upper limit? That is upper class boundary of first class 2, then for second class 4, then 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and last is 16. Take upper class boundary, that is upper limit on x axis and the frequency, sorry, LCF value on y axis and plot the points on xy plane. For the class boundary 2, what is the LCF value? It's 12. Then for 4, it's 34. Then for 6, it's 62. Then for 8, it's 100. Then for 10, it's 137. Then for 12, it's 166. Then for 14, it's 186. And last for 16, it's 200. Now join these points by the smooth curve called as the less than Ogive curve. Then how to calculate the values Q1, Q2, Q3 by using graph? See, for finding the value of Q1, put I is equal to 1. And at that time, what is the value of IN divided by 4? So IN divided by 4 value is 50. For Q2, what is the value of IN divided by 4? It's 100. And for Q3, what is the value of IN divided by 4? That is 150. See the points 50, 100 and 150 on y-axis. Okay, so here the point 50, then 100 and 150. Now, draw the horizontal line up to the curve, okay, and the point where the horizontal line intersect on curve, draw the perpendicular bisector on x-axis. Wherever the point touches the line or meets the line on x-axis, that point is your quartile value. So this is the value of q1, then here q2, and here the q3. Okay, so this is the method of finding the quartiles values by using the graphs. Okay, now see the merits and demerits of quartiles. So first merit of quartiles is it is simple to understand and easy to calculate. It is calculated by graphically, yes, by using the ogive curve. It is least affected by extreme observations. Okay, it is calculated for qualitative data and it is calculated for open end classes also. Now the demerits are, it is not based on all observations, it is not rigidly defined, and it is not capable for further mathematical treatments. The merits of quartiles is same as the median. Okay, the merits of median are simple to understand, calculated by graphically, least affected, calculated for qualitative data, open end classes. Same here, the merits of quartiles is also same. Okay, so these are the merits and demerits of quartile. Now in next lecture we will see the next measure of central tendency, name is deciles. Thank you.